let me look at that nickel.
You look at that nickel.
No, because I was thinking it was, you know what? This is an old friggin' nickel.
I know.
You know what it is?
No.
It's a shield.
Is it?
It's a friggin' shield nickel.
Are you kidding me?
Shield nickel.
Oh, wow.
Shield nickel.
See that? We were just thinking this whole place is filled with trash, but, you know, thanks to spotting
it looks like a hunter's the patterns perch of a shield nickel.
You know, and my GoPro battery's gonna die, so.
And, which means this would be an Indian. A fatty.
That's old.
That's the 1860 to 1864.
Hell yeah. All right, well.
Okay, so let me make a judgment here. Okay, turn on your.
Oh, it's on.
Okay, so Ryan says something with old spills. So he has a shield nickel here that I can faintly see the imprint on. It's gonna be hard to clean, but you can see the shield. Okay, so that would make the shield nickels were made from 1866 to 1883. The
roughly.
Fatty, and look at that. That's a fatty, that's thick. So that is 1860 to 1864, I believe, were the fatties. That he should be able to get a date on.
Those so two, good, I don't even want good, to try to clean.
Good dig, so here.
Thank you, sir.
You know what?
You know, and those rang in the 50s to 60s.
Well, hey there, fellow diggers. Anyway, I'm out with Ryan at our new, I want to say, survey dig. So Ryan's found a spill. I found a nice weedy penny. But anyway, I got this mixed signal, you know, from the 60s up to about 82, 83. So definite dig. I dig it up, and I see right away whatever it is broken. And it's a small broken coin, but I almost swear I can see what looks like Georges on it. And so the Georges would indicate it's a King George coin, but it's small. So that doesn't correspond to half penny or penny size. So until I clean it and I see what it actually says, you know, we'll find out, but it's thick.
I see what you see. In fact, it's cut in half. That means it was at least made in the same dates that these were in circulation. I know, I forget what certain years and coin styles, there were a lot of counterfeits around here.
Yeah, I know, but the problem is that this is way too small.
Yep. Hey, copper, there you go.
I mean, that's not penny, half penny is the size of our, you know, of our large sense.
Yeah, I'm almost bottle cap size.
So anyway,
hey,
I found congrats. A keeper.
Awesome.
Oh yeah, this is old, nice virgin soil.
I think it's time you start bringing your GoPro with you. Mount it like how I got mine.
Some kind of leather strap. Oh, I just broke it. No, look at this. Some kind of a leather strap.
Shoe strap.
Whatever is here, I'm gonna look. Still has the fabric and the rivets on. That's old.
That could be part of a horse saddle too.
Yeah. Well, I think horse saddles. I think money.
Oh no. Yeah. You know what?
What?
That's a handle.
Yeah.
That's a handle, and this is the original fabric. See, this is it would have came over like this.
Yep.
It would have been another rivet.
That's the first time I've seen some thread on buttons. But
I'll stay, keep you guys tuned in, and if we find anything else here.
Old rivet.
Battery's going.
Six inches deep.
All right, so he just found the other side to the handle of that bag.
And I see the old leather, and this is like cowhide. But you see the strap, you see the bag, and
those
rivets are obviously very... Well, I don't want to say old. I have no clue. But
you did just find that half of that coin here, too, right in the same 10-foot area.
Yeah, so we are going to do a search. Like, maybe this could have been a British soldier's bag. you know, horseback. So it's spread over this area. We have to look. Okay.
Stay tuned.
So what I see here is that horse fire there, and here's the rest of the bag. I'm kind of like, it's disintegrating in my fingers.
Yeah, that big chunk looks like moss.
It's just now the strap handle.
So that means the rest of the bag is here.
That's the rest of the bag right here. And there's just the rivets that I'll pop off and clean to get an idea of date.
Yeah, they could have a maker's mark.
But they're different sizes, so these are handmade rivets.
Oh, this
I mean, you
can
tell by looking at them, they're not machine made. So, hey, I don't know.